What will this do? Sum equal to 0. For j equal to 0, j less than n, j equal to j plus 1, sum equal to sum plus a of ij. I obviously remaining constant throughout the loop. What does I stand for? Row number. Yeah, and j is varying from 0 to n, that is 0 to n minus 1. That means you are going for addition of a I 0 plus a I 1 plus a I 2 plus etc. up to plus a I n minus 1. This value will be there in sum. So ultimately this loop will give me sum of ith row elements. Any doubt? No. For I equal to 0, I less than m, I equal to I plus 1, sum equal to sum plus a of ij. Now j is constant in this loop. It will be sum of column number j. It is sum of column z. That is actually sum equal to a of 0z plus a of 1z plus etc. plus a of m minus 1z. For I equal to 0, I less than n, I equal to I plus 1. For j equal to 0, j less than I, j equal to j plus 1, sum equal to sum plus a of ij. पढ़ा करो यार, क्या उस जगह का प्रॉब्लम है क्या? क्या उधर बैठ के लोग फेंकते क्यों है यार? What will this do? Initially, why don't you make columns यार, I and J. When I is 0, J goes up to, condition is false, it won't enter into the inner loop, because 0 less than 0 will be false, so nothing will be added. I becoming 1, J takes value 0, and then J becomes 1, so 0 ke liye execute nahi hota ye, 1 ke liye execute nahi hoga. I becomes 2, J takes value 0, then 1, and at 2 it is false. I becomes 3, J becomes 0, then 1, then 2, then 3. 3 may it is false. So if you consider this, then you will find that it is a 1 0 will be added. From here it will add a 2 0 a 2 1 ij ij. From here it will add a 3 0 a 3 1 a 3 2, like that. Ultimately it is the sum of the lower triangular elements. This is the sum of the lower triangular elements of the matrix. Okay, make a note. Just the individual loops. We are not going for reading that matrix and anything like that. It's a standard thing that we are doing. Sum of ith row, sum of jth column, sum of the lower triangular elements. Anybody has any doubt, ask me. Instead of going for the generalization, I am giving you the code and now we are understanding it. first one is sum equal to 0 for j equal to 0, j less than n, j equal to j plus 1, sum equal to sum plus aij. That is sum of all the elements in ith row, row number I. That is sum equal to ai0 plus ai1 plus ai2 etc. up to an minus 1. Then again for when sum is 0, I equal to 0, I less than m, I equal to I plus 1, sum equal to sum plus A of ij. It is going to be the sum of column number j. That is, it will be sum equal to A of 0j plus A of 1j plus A of 2j etc. up to A of m minus 1j. And then the lower triangular element. On the same lines, we can have the upper triangular elements. Now I want you to generalize. It is a 0 0, a 0 1, a 0 2, a 0 3, a 0 4, a 1 0, a 1 1, a 1 2, a 1 3, a 1 4, a 2 0, a 2 1, a 2 2, a 2 3, a 2 4, a 3 0, a 3 1, a 3 2, a 3 3. A 3 4 and A 4 0, A 4 1, A 4 2, A 4 3, A 4 4 is the matrix. I want you to find the sum of all the elements of the upper triangle. What the previous loop is giving me was the sum of the lower triangular elements. You will obviously start with sum equal to 0 and you will be considering all the rows, that is for I equal to 0, I less than n, I equal to I plus 1. For now, when you want to start in row number I, you are starting from position 0 1, row number 0 mein. Row number 1 mein you are starting from column 2. Row number 2 mein you are starting from column 3. So ultimately the starting column number is 1 ahead of the row number. So j equal to I plus 1, j less than n, j equal to j plus 1, sum equal to sum plus A of ij is the sum of the upper triangle. What happened? Right. 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 No. Why should I go for such a minute observation? Even in the previous case, when I considered the lower triangle, I was having I equal to 0 initially, j becoming 0. And it was not entering into the inner loop. So a 0 0 was not added at that time. Similarly, in this case, a n minus 1, n minus 1 will not be added. Check it. When I becomes n minus 1, j becomes n. N less than n is false. No doubt the loops will be executed once again, but that doesn't matter. In the previous case, then in that case, I should have started with I equal to 1 because it was not working at that.
So what if we just keep the previous loop as it was for the lower triangle?
We don't want to play tricks with the positions of I and j. That will hamper your thinking through and through. When I am saying that it will be always I standing for row number and j as column number, then it should go like that.
Okay.
and I am always moving in the matrix unless otherwise stated horizontally. What you are trying to say is interchange the inner and outer for loop. In that case, you will be going for the addition vertically. That's what I am saying. Keeping the loop as they are, and instead of having ij write it as ji, the addition won't be horizontal, it will be vertical. Check it. I am still going horizontally. All the additions are performed horizontally. Now I have considered all this. Just tell me whether you understand some big code like for I equal to 0, I less than n, I equal to I plus 1, sum equal to 0, for j equal to 0, j less than n, j equal to j plus 1, sum equal to sum plus a of ij, a of I n is equal to sum. This part, if you look at it, is something that we have already considered today. That was the very, very first code. That is going to find the sum of row number I. Where am I storing it? I have calculated that sum and I am storing it at a particular position. What is that position? I n, that is which position? That is not last, after that. Last position is a I n minus 1. I am not overwriting the last element. I am going ahead, and after this element, here I am storing the sum of row 0. And if you run this loop, initially I is 0, so it will find out sum of row number 0. And we'll store it at 0n position. So I am adding extra column, such that this extra column that I add over here, last column, that will contain respectively the sum of each element, each row. Okay? Exactly on the other lines, now by interchanging I and j, I can go for finding the sum of each column and storing it below, or writing the loops separately. Even that can be done. And for that, I will have to say for j equal to 0, j less than n, j equal to j plus 1, again sum equal to 0, for I equal to 0, I less than n, I equal to I plus 1, sum equal to sum plus a of ij, and then a of nj equal to sum, will fill up one extra row, which will be addition of the respective column. So addition of all these elements will go here. All these elements over here, and all these elements over here. Okay. Obviously, this position over here should be what? This last position over here should be, I have not yet filled it. Position is ANN. Value. Logically, what should be the value over there? Abhi to humne nahi likhi hai. Sum of all the elements. How do I find that? Sum of all the elements of the matrix. I want some intelligent answer. Nahi to mujhe bhi pata hai ke, don't initialize this sum. If you just write a loop sum equal to 0, for I equal to 0 to n, j equal to 0 to n, sum equal to sum plus a of ij, I will get sum of all the elements, which I will store it as a n n. But even more than that, better answer than that, lower triangle plus upper triangle plus diagonal, yes. Yeah, using for loop you can add all the elements of the last column that we have added, or last row, or last row, because both those sums will come out to be same. Here logically accept it. So I will have to write one more for loop. I would have gone for less than or equal to. Because up to this sum you have understood. Now I have already generated this column. Now just add them, no? That is column number Z. So we don't require any extra loop. Making this, why I am doing this is just to get the sum of all the elements also, without writing a loop for it, any extra loop. Existing execution time will be the same, yes, but the code size will be much less because you are omitting almost 4 lines. Instead of writing two nested for loops, can the job be done in a single for loop, matlab one nesting? Assuming this to be a square matrix, assuming it to be a square, it is square, I am using it as square. Of course, इस केस में अगर m और n भी होते थे तो भी ये चलता है, that's not a big issue. Are you getting any hint from here? A of I n equal to 0 and A of n I equal to 0. So when I is 0, it will be 0 n. That means this will be set to 0. And n 0, this was row number n minus 1, this is row n, this will be set to 0. A of I n equal to A of I n plus A of I j. What will this do? It was like sum equal to sum plus A of I j. Only thing is, instead of using new variable sum, I am using this location itself. I will still get the sum over there. This was easy to understand. Let us make it complicated. It will be A of ni equal to A of ni plus A of zi. Now, why? Have you understood the first line? Ha, A of in manje sum dar magacha. It's the same thing. Sum equal to sum plus A of i j. That was summing ith row. फक्त आता सम मध्ये स्टोर करायच्या ऐवजी आई एम स्टोरिंग इट इन ए ऑफ आय एन. मगाशी मी सम फाइंड आउट केले आणि देन आय वॉज कॉपिंग इट टू ए ऑफ आय एन. नाऊ आय एम डायरेक्टली ॲडिंग इट टू ए ऑफ आय एन, दॅट्स वाय आय हॅव इनिशियलाइज्ड इट टू झिरो. सो दिस एलिमेंट विल बी ॲडेड. होता कसे देखो, वेन आय इज झिरो जे इज झिरो, फर्स्ट यू ॲक्सेप्ट दॅट दीज टू एलिमेंट्स आर दीज टू विच आर मेड झिरो, देन जे बिकम्स झिरो. सो ए झिरो झिरो विल बी ॲडेड टू ए झिरो एन. So this value will be added over here, correct? And then again n zero position mein yahan pe I will be adding a zero zero only. What is a zero zero element at that time? This same element. So one element gets added here and this element gets added here when j is zero. When j becomes one, I n and n I, these will remain the same two positions. I j when I add, that means 0 1, that means this element will be added here. And then when I say ZI, it will be 1 0 element will be added here. Okay. Then Z becomes 2, this element will be added here, this element will be added here. Like that, when this inner loop completes its execution once, these two elements are properly set. I becomes 2. I will put this as 0, this as 0, this row, this element will be added to this as well as this. Confusion? No. This element will be added to this, this element will be added to this, obviously. Then this element will be added to both. Then this will be added over here and this will be added over here. Symmetry se add karta jata. Diagonal symmetry se. It will be added. Now here I am making that particular thing that now I does not really mean the row number. It simultaneously finds out the sum of ith row, ith column, then goes for the next one. Again next row, next column. So the these two, then these two, then these two, then these two, then these two. That's how it finds out. But in this loop I cannot make any changes to find out the last value. That cannot be done. Now tell me what assignments you have in the matrices in the college apart from finding the value of the determinant. Are we comfortable with the positions in the matrix? Because without that we cannot proceed further. One should precisely know what we are doing, where we are. As an exercise, one can try this. A square matrix, need not be square, you can take anything. I want you to fill the values like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 17, 18, 19, 20. fill the matrix in the spiral form. Just to make it sure that you precisely know where you are. Filling the matrix in the spiral form. This exercise, I am leaving it to you. Try it. No, none of the elements should be misplaced. Huh? None of the elements should be repeated also. And it should not go into infinite loop. Because there will be several loops which will be coming into picture. Because this loop is incrementing z. When I is constant, this loop is j is constant increment in I, whereas this loop will be j is decremented, I is constant, whereas this loop will be I is decremented, j is constant. This loop ke vakt I is 0, this loop ke vakt j is n minus 1, this loop ke vakt I is n minus 1, and this loop mein j will be 0. Ye to pehli baar hua. Next time it changes. Then it will be I equal to 1. But then it should not start with 0th column also. And should not go up to the last column also. One needs to generalize in the best possible manner. Addition of two matrices. A having size m1 by n1 and B having size m2 by n2 to be added. The condition for the addition is their size should be same. You will have to check these two, without which you cannot proceed. Should we write the code or should we write the function? Function. I will be passing float A having size m1 n1, then float B having size m2 n2, and of course the addition will be stored in matrix C having 20 columns. Function is to return int. because you cannot pass the size of C. You don't know whether it will be added or not. These two could be added or not. If they are added successfully, then this ADMAT will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. It will be the external responsibility to set the size of matrix C, which we cannot return because we cannot return two different values. A function at a time can return only one value. And if you are trying to return the size, you will be returning two values, number of rows and number of columns. So instead of that, I am asking the ADMAT function to return true or false, because I already know what is size of A and size of B. So outside I can calculate size of C. It cannot be done inside the function, at least at this time. If M1 is equal to M2, that is both the matrices have same number of rows, and N1 is equal to N2, then and then only the addition can be performed. How that addition will be performed? For I equal to 0, I less than M1, I equal to I plus 1, for j equal to 0, j less than n1, j equal to j plus 1. Whenever two matrices are added, the respective positions will be added. A00 will be added to B00 to give C00, and that's why it will be C of ij will have the value as A of ij plus B of ij. So I pick up 00 element from A, 00 element from B, addition is stored as C00, j becomes 1. So A01 element added to B01 element, addition will be stored as C01. A02 added to B02 giving us C02. Like that, first the first row will be added, then we increment I, j becomes 0, A10 added to B10 giving us C10. Like that it will continue. And we'll add all the elements, whether I write M1 over here or M2, N1 or N2, doesn't make any difference because they are equal. Addition is performed, I will say return 1, true, job is done. Else I will say return 0. When you call this function from main, you will have to call it as, if ADMAT A comma M1 N1 B comma M2 N2 comma C. If it is true, then M3 is equal to M1, N3 is equal to N1. Okay, ADMAT has said that it has performed the addition, so I can pick up the sizes. Okay, so that's what I was saying earlier. I require these two values which I cannot return. I can return only one value at a time. So this is how it should be called. Make a note. Why?
So you have to print.
Job was not to print, job was to add. Now if main desires to print it, main will print it. I have already said right at the beginning that we are not going to share the responsibility of unnecessarily printing the data. Unless it is exclusively said that add two matrices and print, I am not going to write the print routine. Yeah, we have already written print matrix, right? Lila is open. Read Lila, it is a print Lila. So from here you can call that. print mat C comma M3 comma M3. That is possible. But we won't share any additional responsibility other than the task that is given to us. This was easy to understand actually, to add two matrices. The difficult task is when we go for multiplication. Multiplication of two matrices. And in multiplication, A00, A01, A02, A03, A10, A11, A12, A13, A20, A21, A22, A23 to be multiplied to matrix B, which is B00, B01, B10, B11, B20, B21, and B30, B31. Can they be multiplied? Yes. Yes. This has got size as 3 rows, 4 columns, and this has size as 4 rows, 2 columns. Resultant will be having 3 rows, 2 columns. See, 00 element over here will be written as A00 B00 plus A01 into B10 plus A02 into B20 plus A03 into B30. C01 element, C01 element will be A00 into B. B01 plus A01 into B11 plus A02 into B21 plus A03 into B31. What is the similarity? You will find that these two are always same. Whatever is the column matrix, column number of the first one is the row number of the second. That's how you actually multiply. Here also. Same. Meaning that when I go for the multiplication, I will have to say that it is going to be C A of I something into B of that something into yahan kuch aur. But it is going to be part of C I Z. So, ye I or J nahi ho sakta, so I will call it as K. Is it okay with everyone? So this C00, I can rewrite it as summation of A 0k into B k0 from k equal to 0 to, we are going for generalization, sizes are m1 by n1 up to n1 minus 1. Can you understand this? Okay. Exactly on the same lines, if I go for writing C01, I will get a picture like k equal to 0 to n1 minus 1, A of 0k into B of k1. Barabara. Will somebody write, help me to write C11 or C10? Sigma k equal to 0 to n1 minus 1 A of 1k into B of k0. Will you tell me C of Ij? Sigma k equal to 0 to n1 minus 1 A of ik into B of kj. Any doubt in this? No. Where I goes from 0 to m1 minus 1 and j goes from 0 to n2 minus 1 and with the condition that m1 is equal to, or rather n1 equal to m2, with the condition that n1 should be equal to m2. How difficult the code could be after writing all this? You can start with saying for I equal to 0, I less than m1, hint is here, I equal to I plus 1, for j equal to 0, j less than n2, j equal to j plus 1. Now I can use C of ij directly, but I am just avoiding that. I am using our standard notion that sum is 0. It is sigma, sum. It should be sum equal to sum plus this element every time for when k varies from 0 to n1 minus 1. So it will be for k equal to 0, k less than n1, k equal to k plus 1, sum equal to sum plus A of ik into B of kj. Anybody has any doubt how I have written this statement? Whatever sum that you have found is actually the value of C of ij. So once this k ka loop gets over, outside I will say C of ij is equal to sum. So initially I is 0, j is 0, sum will be set to 0, it will perform the addition like A 0 0 B 0 0 plus A 0 1 B 1 0 plus A 0 2 B 2 0 plus A 0 3 B 3 0, that will be value of sum, that sum will be stored as C 0 0, j gets incremented becomes 1, C 0 1, it will be A 0 0 into B 0 1 plus A 0 1 into B 1 1, like that all the elements. Sum will be copied to A C of 0 1, like that it will continue and will give you the product. Now why I am not writing the function? Because everything is same. Add mat ke bajaye multiply mat, parameters remain same. You require one extra variable k, okay, and you the condition changes that this is to be done if n1 is equal to m2, then only perform this and return 1, otherwise return 0. That will be multiply. Generalization is important, make a note of it. Which steps we have followed? We did not take the values. We started with the position, the naming. From that we have generalized first the indices, second one. Then we had gone for sigma notation. This sigma notation we have generalized in Isaac. And then we had gone for the code, and then it is easy. What does add mat return?
So but why if before adding
one? Because it tells me whether the addition has been done or not. Returning 1 is returning true.
So but at M3 and M3 we are using this. M3 is equal to M1 and M3 is equal to M1.
Huh. Those are the sizes of matrix C. If M1, N1 you have understood as size of A. If M2, M2 are size of B, then M3, N3 will be size of C. That has to be set now. Every matrix will have externally stored its size.
So this
is C's size. Yeah, that's what I was saying. Okay, size of the matrix will be two values and I can return only one. So setting the size should be done externally. Same thing over here.
So that means if it returns 1, the function will return 1, then this will execute.
Yeah, and then M3 and 3 will get the value.
It will not execute, it does come out of the loop. Right?
Yeah, otherwise you can set M3 equal to 0, N3 equal to 0. That means matrix C does not exist elsewhere. And here also you will give the call in the same manner. If multiply matrix, then M3 equal to M1 and N3 equal to N2 this time. Exactly the same way.